Good morning, friends. Myself, Ankit Patwari, back again. So today, our topic of discussion will be matching principle. I told you in my initial lectures that whenever you do accounting, you have to take a lot of assumptions. There are a lot of concepts that you have to follow. Accounting works within a framework. So today here, we will be discussing matching principle. Now, so what is this matching principle? Basically, this is the principle followed when you prepare profit and loss account. When you determine net profit, so you have to keep in mind matching principle. Now, matching principle bolta kya hai? Matching principle says that all expenses are to be matched with the revenue of the current year. What does matching principle says? All expenses are to be matched with the revenue of current financial year. Now, I'll take three examples. I'll take purchases, I'll take rent, and I'll take fixed asset. Three examples I'll take: purchases, rent, and fixed asset. Suppose we purchase 10,000 units and we have sold 8,000 units. So what do you do? Initially, we record purchase as expense 10,000 units and we record sales revenue for 8,000 units. When we prepare profit and loss account, so we have to show stock in hand 2,000 units. This is because of matching principle. So the moment you show closing stock on the opposite side of profit statement, so effectively you get purchase minus closing stock, that is cost of goods sold. It means now my purchase expense is perfectly matched with the sales revenue. Is that fine? So if I say purchase is adjusted, if I say purchase is adjusted, it means adjustment as per matching principle has already been done. So this is with respect to purchase, that you need to show stock in hand so that expenses gets perfectly matched with the revenue of the current financial year. Jitna humne kamaya hai, jitna hamara sales hai, usi basis pe hum log apna expenses ko show karenge. Agar hamara PL ka credit side mein revenue 8,000 units ka hai, but initially purchase ko expense maine 10,000 units se dikhaya tha, so right on the opposite side, or I'll deduct, show as a deduction from purchase, 2,000 units stock in hand, so effectively I get purchase for 8,000 units and revenue of 8,000 units. So here I will get profit for 8,000 units. Is that fine? Second item, let us take rent. Now rent also needs to be matched with the revenue of current financial year. Now rent ek aisa expenses hai jo revenue se related nahi hai, but time se zarur related hai. Right? Purchase mera revenue se directly related tha, to uska direct matching hua. Aisa koi kharcha jo purchase se related, revenue se related agar nahi hai, to uska matching hum log टाइम के साथ करेंगे. जैसे हमारा अकाउंटिंग पीरियड 12 महीने का होता है, तो रेंट वी विल शो फॉर 12 मंथ्स. दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज सिमिलर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू अक्रूअल बेसिस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग. अक्रूअल बेसिस में भी हम लोग ऐसा ही करते हैं. इफ यू पे रेंट फॉर 11 मंथ्स, वी शो एक्सपेंस फॉर 12 मंथ्स, एक महीने का आउटस्टैंडिंग दिखाते हैं. इफ आई पे रेंट फॉर 13 मंथ्स, आई विल शो एक्सपेंस फॉर 12 मंथ्स, एक महीने का वी शो प्रीपेड. यस और नो? सो परचेस नीड्स टू बी मैच विद सेल्स, rent needs to be done matching with time. Let us talk about fixed asset. Fixed asset ka matching kaise hota hai? Fixed assets are a resources jisko main business mein use karunga for more than one accounting period. Matlab fixed asset ek aisa resources hai that will help me in deriving revenue for more than one accounting year. So that is why jo cost of fixed asset hai, that needs to be spread over the useful life of the asset. That needs to be spread over the useful life of the asset. Right? So, मैंने आपको तीन आइटम बताया. पहला आइटम मैंने आपको परचेस बताया. परचेस का मैचिंग हम लोग रेवेन्यू के साथ करेंगे. एक्सपेंस दैट इज रेंट सैलरी, इसका मैचिंग हम लोग टाइम के साथ करेंगे. एंड कॉस्ट ऑफ द एसेट को हम लोग मैचिंग ओवर द ईयर्स उसको स्प्रेड कर देंगे. Because that particular asset will help us in deriving revenue not only for current year, it will help us in deriving revenue for more than one accounting year. So, jo bhi hamara cost of the asset hai, usko hum log spread kar denge over the useful life of the asset. So, if I tell you what is net profit, what is net profit? So, that is sales revenue minus adjusted purchases, mark my words, and that adjusted purchase is known as COGS, minus rent as per accrual basis of accounting, means you need to match rent with time, minus cost of the asset spread, and the cost of the asset spread ko apne bolte hai depreciation. The difference is my net profit. Is that fine? So today we have discussed matching principle, jo bolta hai all expenses are to be matched with the revenue of the current financial year. Kuch kuch kharche aise hote hain jiska relation directly sales ke saath hota hai, usko directly matching karke dikhayenge. Jiska sales ke saath relation nahi hai, usko time ke saath match karke dikhayenge. And kuch kuch kharcha aisa hota hai jisse mere ko benefit aur ya mere se usse related mere ko profit aane wala more than one accounting year mein hone wala hai, to usko hum log spread karke dikhayenge. So what is the formula for net profit? It's sales revenue minus not purchases, it's adjusted purchases, minus rent as per accrual basis, minus not cost of the asset, the spread of the cost of the asset, that is depreciation. So thank you so much. In next class, we'll be back with some more concepts. Namaste.